On your computer right now, there are sneaky little things that are eating up your computer's RAM. And this is even before you open up any app on your computer. This can cause major memory pressure and slows down your computer's performance. And in this video, I'll show you what the culprits are and how to manage it. I'm Raphael and welcome to the channel where our goal is to always fix it in camera and then finesse it in post. And there is nothing worse than your computer slowing down when you are in a creative flow. This is something that I advocate for, to have a system that will keep up with you and not the other way around, and to ultimately get as much RAM as you can afford. But even with more RAM, your system can still be bogged down, sometimes as soon as you start it up. Most people are familiar with memory hogs such as After Effects, Photoshop, Premiere, Final Cut Pro, and other creative apps that will take as much RAM as you have on your system. But a lot of time, it's the background processes that eat up a good chunk of your RAM even before opening up anything. For example, on a fresh boot up on my system, it's already idling between 5 to 7 gigabytes, and this is with having none of the apps that I actually use open. This RAM is being eaten up by all the startup processes. So if you had an 8 gigabyte system, there would only be 3 gigs of actual RAM to use for everything else. And on a 16 gigabyte system, there would be just enough to handle everything, but I'll talk about why a little bit later in the video. Now, granted, this is my system that has 5 gigabytes on startup. What about other people? Surely my system is unique. Well, I did a poll on YouTube, Instagram, and Twitter, and I also canvassed everyone that I knew, and the vast majority all were around the same memory pressure just on boot up. There were a few that were below the 3 gigabyte memory pressure, but all of them didn't use any of the heavy apps like Photoshop, After Effects, Premiere, Final Cut, or DaVinci, meaning they didn't have Adobe Creative Cloud, which has many small apps that launch at startups. Or another big app that they didn't use is Dropbox, which itself almost uses 2 gigabytes just as you start up your system. But even still, with the minimum startup apps, that means that the OS is eating up around 3 gigabytes of RAM just by itself. And on an 8 gig system, that's nearly half. And most apps have 4 gigs of minimum recommended system requirements. And most creative apps today require 16 gigs of system memory as the minimum. After Effects is notorious for hogging RAM. And as soon as you open up the app, the memory pressure jumps up. And if you start previewing a comp, it will eat up as much RAM as you allow it to. And it's good to know that you can purge a lot of the After Effects memory from the RAM. With Final Cut, the same thing happens. The memory pressure jumps significantly. And this happens with every app that you open. So depending on which apps you use, just know that each one will use as much RAM as you can give it. So can you see how this can become a problem very quickly? Now, I know that there is swap memory that plays a huge part in lower RAM systems. And this is where the OS tries its best to keep processes going and uses the SSD as a RAM substitute. But the SSD is not as fast as the RAM. And on modern systems today, RAM is up to 100 times faster than the SSD with read and write. RAM is the memory that pretty much is directly accessed by the CPU. And for tasks the CPU is doing to keep functioning smoothly, the response time has to be quick. RAM, even older DDR RAM, is measured in nanoseconds, where SSDs are measured in milliseconds. RAM is faster. Cool. So now, how do we ensure that we're using the most of it for what we need and keep the memory pressure down? The goal should be to keep RAM in play and avoid swap memory as much as possible. So the first thing that anyone can do, and this is an obvious answer, is to buy as much RAM as you can afford that will fit into your system. But that is only if you're considering or ready to buy a new system right now. So the second thing is to manage your apps to prioritize where and when the RAM is used. Safari and Chrome are notorious big RAM users, especially if you have multiple tabs open. Each tab is eating up RAM. That means a YouTube page will try to load and store 500 megabytes or higher for each tab. So if you're not watching that YouTube video, put it into your watch later list and close all those tabs. This will free up lots of RAM and reduce the swap memory that you're using. If you have Dropbox installed and don't use it that often, quit it if you don't need to have it running. And do all your syncing at night. Turn off all the apps that you're not currently using, even the small ones. It may not seem like much, but they all do add up. And some of those small apps can open up background processes that eat up even more RAM. Another thing is to find out which apps are actually starting up at launch. And this is something that happens as you install the app. It just has it on as a default. So you actually need to go digging and look for those apps that are launching on startup that you don't actually use. And you can find them in your system preferences under users and groups, under the login items tab. Turn off anything that you don't need. You can also check on the dock right click on the app icon, select options, turn off open at login. Another thing that you can do is just do a hard reboot. This typically will purge the RAM and give you a snappier system. So if you're one of those people that loves to leave your computer on day after day, just know that a reboot may solve a lot of your problems and give you a smoother experience. One of the biggest reasons you want to avoid using swap memory, as awesome as it is that RAM is so much faster for the processes that you're doing. And the more RAM you can use for the apps that you need, it'll make your whole experience working with the computer much better. Swap memory is fantastic, but if you're using your SSD as RAM and your projects are also on the SSD, your computer will be fighting to which to prioritize to grab your project or to grab the other processes that it needs. And this is another thing that can slow down your system. If you've managed your apps and your RAM, but you're still experiencing memory pressure often, it may be time to consider an upgrade. And this video may help you decide between the Mac Mini and the Mac Studio, and which is best for you. Also, I live stream on my second channel where I deep dive on the creative process as well as freelance financials. So make sure you check that out. As always, thanks for watching.